Yes. Mrs. Williams.
Mr. Worth.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Tell me, has he been yet?
Has who been yet?
The postman is usually here by 9 o'clock, and it's 9 o'clock already.
Oh, don't worry. He'll be here any minute now.
Yes, that's what I'm afraid of. My bedroom.
I haven't finished down here yet.
Yes, well, I'll do what there is to do, Mrs. Williams. There you are, place for everything. Everything in its place. I thought you were going upstairs.
Oh, all right.
There's a good girl. Now, all I have to do is wait for the postman. Ah, but did they send the shoes? Is that the thing? Phone the shop. Yes. Hello, yes. December the 5th with a red ring round it, that's right.
Number, please.
I beg your pardon?
Number, please.
Ah, this is where we usually have the trouble, isn't it? If you remember, the last time I phoned you and you said number, please, I inadvertently bent down and gave you my own number, whereas you wanted the number I was ringing. It was all very confusing.
Yes, yes, yes. Now, can we proceed with your call, please?
Yes. Oh, just one moment. I want to make sure that Mrs. Williams is still upstairs. I won't be a moment.
I got a right one here. This fella's balmy.
What number is it?
Woodbridge 487.
48? Oh, that explains it. Harry Worth.
Harry Worth?
Yes, the best of luck.
I say, it's all right. She's still upstairs.
Then number, please.
Woodbridge 487.
What number do you want?
Oh, I made the same mistake I did before dinner. I do apologize.
Mr. Worth. To whom do you wish to speak?
Well, he's a rather tall gentleman wearing glasses, and very helpful he is.
I'm afraid I don't understand.
Well, there's no reason why you should. Now, I will explain. You see, today is Mrs. Williams' birthday. I'm sending her a pair of bedroom slippers. I want to phone Simpson's Shoe Shop to find out if they posted them.
At last.
Yes, it's always better to get things quite clear.
And what is the number of the shoe shop?
68, or is it 86? Anyways, next door to the Woodbridge Pet Shop.
What is the telephone number?
Of the pet shop?
No, the shoe shop!
You mustn't shout like that. Mrs. Williams might hear you.
Please, will you give me the telephone number of the shoe shop?
Certainly, Woodbridge 722.
Thank you. I'll try to connect you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Miss Williams. Happy birthday to you.
Simpson's Shoes, good morning.
This is Harry Worth speaking.
Yes. Would you mind speaking a little louder, please, Mr. Worth?
No, I'm afraid I can't. You see, Mrs. Williams might hear me.
Mrs. who?
Mrs. Williams.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Williams! Mrs. Williams!
Did you call me, sir?
No, it's all right, dear. You go back upstairs.
But you're not going to sworn you shouted, mate.
No, dear, you've been hearing things. Now, go back. Hello? Now, did you send the slippers for Mrs. Williams?
Now, this was to number 52 Acacia Avenue.
Right.
Yes, sir, that's all right. They were sent off last night. Your postman should be delivering them this morning.
Good. Now, I want to watch out for the postman, so you won't think I'm rude if I ring off, will you?
Not at all.
Thank you very much.
Looking for someone?
Yes, Mrs. Williams, I'm looking for the postman. Mrs. Williams, what are you doing downstairs?
Well, I've finished upstairs.
What about the bathroom?
I've done the bathroom.
Yeah, spare room.
And the spare room and the landing.
Well, you must be worn out. Why don't you go upstairs and lie down?
Oh, Mr. Worth, yes? You know, you're acting very strange this morning. Are you sure you feel all right?
Oh, yeah, I feel marvellous, really. The postman, I'll go.
Oh, it might be the milkman. I'd better go.
No, Mr. Worth. No ifs or buts, dear. Why don't you go upstairs and clean the picture rail, polish the wardrobe, dust my bedside lamp.
You haven't got a bedside lamp.
You're quite right. I'll go out and buy one while you do the other job. Off you go.
I don't know what all the mystery's about, I'm sure.
You don't, but you'll soon find out. Coming.
Anything for me this morning?
I've got a couple for you, Mr. Jenkins.
I've been waiting for you all. It must have been the back door. I went to the front door and... Oh, it was the front door.
Come on, Mr. Worth. Always the same at this house.
Thank goodness I'm being transferred today. I'll try the back.
Well, I can't... Well, I'm sure I heard somebody knocking.
Hello, Mr. Worth. Anybody in?
Ah, there you are. Come in.
I think you better come in.
I would have come sooner, only there was someone at the front door. It's all right. Come on in. The coast is clear.
Now, look here, Mr. Worth.
Shh, Mrs. Williams. She might hear you. Did you bring the parcel?
Here. And you owe me fivepence on this letter. There's no stamp on it.
Never mind that. Just think this parcel is going to bring great pleasure to a dear old lady. Pardon me. Would you do me a favor?
What sort of a favor?
Well, would you join me in singing Happy Birthday to You, Mrs. Williams?
Look, I'm a postman, not a choir boy.
Ah, please, it would give Mrs. Williams so much pleasure, and you won't regret it. Now, imagine the scene. She will walk in, I will present her with the slippers, then you and I together will sing Happy Birthday to You, Mrs. Williams. I could do it on my own, but together it will be richer, fuller, more impact. Besides, I'm not sure of the words.
All right, anything for a quiet life. Come on, let's get it over with.
Good man. Mrs. Williams.
Coming.
Yes, Mr.
Worth? Mrs. Williams, you have served me well for the past 2 years. Day after day, you have washed my shirts and darned my socks without a word of complaint or even a drop of detergent. Now, today, I am taking the opportunity to show my gratitude by presenting you with this small gift, a token of my esteem.
Oh. Happy birthday.
No, not yet. After three, or it'll sound all raggedy. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mrs. Williams. Happy birthday to you.
You shouldn't have done it.
Nonsense. Open the parcel, Mrs. Williams. Open it.
I don't want to seem ungrateful, and I'm sure I do appreciate the thought behind the gift, but there's one thing I must say.
Well, it isn't necessary, but if you feel you must, go on.
It's not my birthday.
It's not her birthday. It's not your birthday.
No. Mine's June the 28th. Don't you remember? You gave me a pair of carpet slippers.
Marvellous. Flipping marvellous.
But it must be a birthday. Look, it's marked on the calendar, the 5th of December, with a red ring. Red for a girl, blue for a boy.
Well, it must have been some other bird, mustn't it?
I don't know any other birds, ladies. The only two ladies in my life are Mrs. Williams and my auntie. Auntie, yes, it's her birthday.
Well, I should take those slippers and give them to your auntie.
That's the answer. No, it isn't. No, they don't fit her.
Well, I'd change them.
Would you?
Yeah.
That's very, very kind of you. Look, it's Simpson's Shoe Shop, tall gentleman with glasses. Mention my name when you go in.
Look, I'm not taking them back for you.
I don't see why not. It's opposite the post office. You could go to him in your lunch hour.
I'm not changing your slippers, and that's final.
Very well. But remember this. The festive season is not far off. It'll be a different story then, won't it? You can't say I've ever forgotten you. Not once have you gone without your mince pie. Remember last year? You got the one with the sixpence in it.
Yeah, all in coppers.
Well, I didn't want to take the risk of anyone swallowing it.
Look, I've got news for you, Mr. Worth.
Yes?
I shan't be here at Christmas. In fact, after today, I shan't be delivering your letters anymore.
Oh. You make me feel very humble, you do really. Here I am going on about a pair of bedroom slippers, and you have reached this state of your life. Oh, it must be a very proud day for me.
What are you talking about?
Well, after all your long years of faithful service, no doubt. They'll present you with a gold watch.
So what?
A gold watch inscribed by the Postmaster General himself. Kind regards, Harold Macmillan. Congratulations, and whatever anyone else says, you don't look 65.
I happen to be 34.
Isn't that a rather early age to retire?
I am not retired. I'm being transferred to another district. And I'm off now. I've had enough.
Now.
Oh, just a minute.
Yes?
What about this letter? You owe me for it. Somebody forgot to put a stamp on it.
You know, they've no right to send letters without putting stamps on it. That's the trouble with people today, isn't it? They never stop to think. They're all rushing, woolly-headed. I wonder who it's from. Let me see. Ah, here we are. Happy birthday to you, Mrs. Williams, from...
Harry.
Well, anyone can make that mistake, can't you? Now, you want a stamp, do you? Very well, I've got a stamp here for you. Mm. Now, you won't forget to deliver this on your way round.
I've already delivered it.
Oh, have you really? Well, you won't require the stamp.
There you are, sir. I think you'll find those very satisfactory.
Thank you very much.
Oh, not at all, sir. We like to give service. That's what we're here for.
Well, good morning.
Good morning to you, sir. Good morning. Well, there goes another satisfied customer, sir.
Good show, Wilson. Keep it up, and you'll soon have a branch of your own to manage.
Oh, sir.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning. Can I help you?
Yeah, well, I'm looking for a tall gentleman with glasses.
Oh, it's you, Mr. Worth. Yeah. What seems to be the trouble now?
Well, it's about these slippers. No,
now, don't tell me they aren't the right size, Mr. Worth. After all the trouble we went through yesterday.
Ah, they're the right size. It's the wrong woman.
I beg your pardon?
Yes, you see, I marked my calendar red for a girl, blue for a boy. Now, when I saw the red ring, I naturally thought it was Mrs. Williams, but it wasn't.
It wasn't?
No, so we must ask ourselves, who is it? And the answer is Auntie. Because the only other lady I know is Miss Petherbridge at the public library. And I hardly think she deserves a red pencil, because I only see her once a month when I go to pay my fine.
Mr. Worth, would you please tell me what it is you're talking about?
It's these slippers. I want a pair to fit Auntie.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, what size slippers does your Auntie wear?
Yes, well, I've got it all written down in my diary. Here we are, 6 7/8.
6 7/8. Well, that's obviously a hat size.
Ah, yes.
Here, let me look.
No, no, Auntie wouldn't like you prying into her vital statistics.
Well, what have you got against hats?
Hats, sea gloves.
And what have you got against gloves?
Gloves, sea slippers.
Look, what is her stocking size?
Stocking size, 19 feet 6 inches. No! I've given you the high tide at London Bridge. They're very useful things, aren't the diaries? If there's anything you ever want to know...
Her stocking size,
please. 9 1/2.
9 1/2. Yeah. Well, that will be about size 5 in slippers.
Yeah. 9 1/2, size 5 in slippers, rather complicated system. Ah, Wellington boots, yes. Marvelous. I've always wanted a pair of Wellington boots. Now, let me see. Put them on there, yes. Marvelous on the top, yes. These are very good. Ah, yes. Hello. I'm just trying them out.
Oh, yes, sir. Can I help you? Would you like to sit down?
Yes, would you take my arm there?
Now, sir, if you'd like to give me your foot.
My foot, yes, there you are.
Sharp tug and off.
Ready?
No, sit down, sir.
Oh.
And hold on to the chair.
Hold on to the chair, yes.
Right, sir.
Yes.
Have a grip.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. And now, sir, are you interested in a pair of Wellingtons?
Not a pair, only that one.
Well, why this particular one?
It has my shoe inside.
Sir, would you mind telling me what you come here for?
Ah, yes, I came about a pair of carpet slippers.
Pair of carpet slippers?
Yes.
Oh, yes, sir. Now then, sir, may I measure your foot?
Measure?
Your foot.
If you wish, yes.
Right.
There's something wrong with that. It's all loose, isn't it?
No, sir. Huh? It's made that way.
Nobody seems to care anymore.
Now, sir, if you like to put your foot on this platform,
yes,
your heel resting on the back, just toe flat, like
yes,
that.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. You take size 8 1/2 in shoes.
Wrong, 9.
Oh, no, sir, 9 would be far too large. Look, 8 1/2.
No, very good guess, but I take a 9.
Sir, I know.
Yes?
Shall we get a size 8 1/2 and try it?
And try it? Yes. Shall we?
Shall we?
All right, then.
Now, if you'd just like to slip your foot in there. That's right. How's that, sir?
My word, yes, you were right. It's 8½, yes.
Well, it's always as well to take the advice of somebody with practical experience, isn't it?
Exactly.
Now, sir, how is that for style?
I like the style very much, yes.
Now, you're
I do.
Sure? Because we've got many styles in our range here that I could show you.
No, no, it isn't necessary. Besides, I'm in a hurry. I've got to get back. It's Auntie's birthday.
Oh, I see. Well, we mustn't keep Auntie waiting,
no,
must we?
No, we mustn't.
No, no.
What a charming man.
Yes, well, here we are, Mr. Ware. One pair of slippers exchanged.
Ah, thank you very much indeed. That's very kind
29
of you.
And 11.
I beg your pardon?
These slippers, 29 and 11.
And very reasonable, too, yes. If I ever want a pair of slippers, those will be the ones I shall get.
Well, now, will they be all right like that, or would you prefer them with gift wrapping?
Gift wrapping? No, 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 they'll be all right as they are, thank you.
Excuse me, sir, do I understand you don't wish to buy these slippers?
No.
Oh, what on earth gave you that idea, Wilson?
Well, sir, nothing, sir. It was just an assumption, that's all.
Ah, well, you'll probably be all right in the morning. Cheerio now, and thank you very much.
Well, really, Wilson, you'll never get a branch of your own that way.
No, sir.
Excuse me. I have changed my mind.
Oh, well, sir, I'm glad to hear that. You won't resist.
I will have it in gift wrapping. If you have paper with happy birthday on and a large bow, I think it would look rather attractive, don't you? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Auntie. Happy birthday to you. Auntie? Auntie, look through the window. It's obvious that Auntie's out. Oh, well, I let myself in. Now, where is the key? Let me see. Sunday's third stone from the left facing the garden. Monday's behind the coal shed. Tuesday's under the mat. Auntie's changed the combination. Very well, I'll let myself in through the window. Oh, the parcel. Ah, Mabel. Yeah, Mabel. Hello, Mabel. Lucas come to see you. It's Uncle Harry. Say hello to Uncle Harry. Go on, say hello. Say hello. Oh, you don't feel like talking, do you? Well, it's no good asking you to join in happy birthday to you, is it? Where is Auntie, by the way? Where's Auntie? Has she gone down to the shop? Has she? Well, she's got a pleasant surprise when she comes back. Yes. Here's Auntie coming now. Not a word out of you, Mabel. Not a word. Come in. Surprise, surprise.
Oh, no.
Tell me, what are you doing here?
Just been transferred to this district.
Well, aren't you lucky?
Am I?
Yes. That means you won't miss your Christmas box after all. Auntie's very good at mince pies, and you might get a drop of elderberry wine.
Yeah, well, something tells me I'll be transferred again before that, tomorrow if possible.
So soon? Where are you going? Tell me, don't they move you about a bit quite a lot in your job? You'll deserve that gold watch by the time you get it. Where are you going this time?
Have you any relatives in Tanganyika?
No, no, I've no relatives.
Good. I'll write out my application tonight.
Okay.
Oh, here, just sign for this registered letter, will you?
Yes, I will.
Here we are.
Thank you very much. One registered letter signed for. There you are.
Thank you. Ah, you got the slippers changed then?
Yes, I'm just waiting for my auntie. She's probably down at the shop.
Yeah, well, the best of luck, mate. I'm off.
Ah, but wait a moment. Aren't you forgetting something?
What?
Happy birthday.
Oh, no, you caught me once and that's enough.
Well, I don't know. Auntie would appreciate it a great deal, and you sang it beautifully this morning.
I'm sorry, Mr. Worth.
No, please, won't you do... Ah, here she is. You will join in, won't you?
All right.
All right, after three. One, two, come in, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear auntie. Happy birthday to you. That is not auntie.
Brilliant. May I ask how you got in here?
You certainly can, officer. I came in by way of the window.
Oh, yes, of course, the window.
Yeah, well, I'm off. Good afternoon.
Just one moment. You better stay here. There might be one or two questions I want to ask you.
I've got nothing to do with him. I just deliver the letters.
Oh, you do you? Well, I happen to know the postman in this area, and you're not him.
I've just been transferred here.
Yes, and he's going to Tanganyika in the morning.
You keep out of this. You started this with all this happy birthday lark.
There is no need to lose your temper. You'll never get a gold watch that way. No, you'll never get a gold watch.
Now, just one moment. Yes. I hope you know it's a very serious thing, you being here.
Well, it's serious, but at the same time, it is rather pleasant. After all, it only happens once a year.
Look, officer, this is all a terrible mistake. Why don't you tell him who you are before he runs us both in? Tell him this is your auntie. He thinks we're a couple of burglars.
Don't be silly. The constable's only to take one look at us to realize we are not a couple of burglars. He thinks that you think that we're a couple of burglars. He does think we're a couple of burglars.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
Yes, well, obviously you're making a mistake. This is my auntie's house.
Do you mean to tell me that Mrs. Prendergast is your auntie?
Yes, she certainly is.
Have you got any proof of that?
Yes, I have. I've got it here. I'm glad you asked me. Well, I give it to you. Oh, yes. Here we are. Hats, 6 7/8. Gloves, sea slippers.
You'll have to do better than that, I'm afraid. In fact, you'll have to prove definitely to me that you are the nephew of Mrs. Prendergast, because if you don't, I shall have no alternative but to place you under arrest.
Under arrest? Mabel.
Mabel?
Yes, Mabel will vouch for me. Mabel, would you tell the nice constable that I am Uncle Harry? Go on, say Uncle Harry.
Uncle Harry!
There you are. Say it again, nice and loud and clear. Uncle Harry! There you are, officer.
All right, come along, Ludwig Koch. That's enough out of you.
But I'm telling you, this is my auntie's home. I'm a nephew. I've come here to give her a birthday present.
There you are, constable. Satisfied? Can I go now?
Not just yet. You happen to know where your auntie is at the moment, sir?
Well, I presume she's down at the shops.
I see. And what would you say if I told you that your auntie had just telephoned us from Bognor Regis?
Well, I would say she changed the grocers.
Well, for your information, I can tell you that she did telephone us not more than half an hour ago to say that she was away for the day. And would we mind coming round here and checking up, because she thinks she may have left the back door unlocked.
There's only one thing wrong with that story, officer. Auntie would not go away on her birthday.
Now, are you sure this is her birthday, sir?
Positive. I never make a mistake about a birthday. Never, 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 never.
Well, I happen to know that Mrs. Prendergast's birthday and mine happened to fall on the same day.
Your birthday today. Congratulations. After three. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Why don't you belt up?
It is the constable's birthday.
It is not my birthday.
But you said it fell on the same day as Auntie.
And so it does. May the 18th.
I knew it.
May the 18th, impossible. Auntie would not like you changing her birthday. She's a Taurus the Bull, you know. Very independent.
Taurus the Bull is May the 18th. It's Sagittarius now.
Sagittarius, are you?
Oh. Found on enclosed premises.
Yes.
Breaking and entering. Mm-hmm. Abstracting a police officer in the course of his duty. Any questions?
Only one, officer.
What's that?
Whose birthday is it?
Now, will you be quiet about that thing? Get out of
the Well, I really am sorry to have caused you all this trouble, and it's very good of you to exchange them again for me.
Not at all. Mm-hmm.
Sorry I kept you so late, too. I would have been here sooner, but I had a little bit of trouble at the police station, but it's all been sorted out.
Well, here we are, Mr. Worth. One pair of slippers exchanged.
Yes, and very nicely wrapped, if I may say so, yes. Are you ready? Here you are.
Oh, now, really, Mr. Worth, I couldn't.
No, I insist, really.
All right.
After three. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.